Determinants of consumption function. J.M. Keynes has divided the factors influencing consumption into two. They are the subjective and the objective factors. So J.M. Keynes has divided factors influencing the consumption function into two, namely the subjective and the objective factors. So what do you mean by subjective factors? Subjective factors are the internal factors related to psychological feeling. It is the factors which are internal. It differs from a person to person. It is just the psychological feeling which a person has. These factors are called as subjective. Major subjective factors are given as below. There are eight motives which lead individuals to refrain from spending. We are talking about the determinants of consumption function. So there are eight motives which lead to individuals to refrain from spending. What do you mean by refrain? Avoid. Sometimes people do not spend all the money. They keep a part of their money as savings. Why do they save the money? Or why do they refrain from spending? Refrain is, why don't they spend all the money? What is the reason for avoiding spending more money? First one, the motive of precaution. What do you mean by precaution? To build up a reserve against unforeseen contingencies. What will happen to me tomorrow if I keep spending all my money? If something happens to me tomorrow, an accident or a sickness, so people tend to save some money for precautionary motive. Precautionary means unforeseen contingencies. We do not know what will happen the very next day to us. So we need to save certain amount. This motive is called as the motive of precaution. The motive of foresight, the desire to provide for anticipated future needs. I am working now, so I am earning. After my retirement, who will take care of me? So for my future, for my old age, I tend to save. This is called as the motive for foresight. First, the motive for precaution is for meeting unforeseen expenditures, such as accidents and sickness. The motive of foresight is for anticipated future needs, such as old age. Next, the motive of calculation. Sometimes, if I save now, the interest rate is very low, so I don't want to save money. And I feel that if I save after a month or two, the interest rate might go up. So I start doing a calculation. This is only called as the motive of calculation. The desire to enjoy interest and appreciation. If the value appreciates or if the value of money increases in the future, I start calculating and I don't spend it today. This is called as the motive of calculation. The motive of improvement. The desire to enjoy for improving the standard of living. I want to increase my standard of living. I want to have all the modern gadgets at home. This is only called the motive of improvement. Then the motive of financial independence. I want to have some independence. I don't want to be dependent on others. So this is called as financial independence, the motive of financial. I want to be independent. I don't want to depend on someone for all my financial needs. This is called as the motive of financial independence. The motive of enterprise. This is the desire to do forward trading. I want to expand my trading. This is called as the motive of enterprise. The desire to do forward trading is called as the motive of enterprise. The motive of pride, I want to bequeath a fortune, I want to have a fortune for the future. This is called as the motive of pride. The motive of avarice. What is avarice? Purely miserly and instinct. I don't want to spend any amount today. I don't want to be spending. I want to be very miserly. I don't want to spend any amount. This is only called as the motive of avarice. Chikkanama irukkanum. I don't want to spend anything today. So these are the eight motives which lead individuals to refrain from spending. There are some motives for the government, institution and firms also. They are as follows. The motive of enterprise. The desire to obtain resources to carry out further capital investment without incurring debt. The government, the institution and the firms, they don't want to incur debt. But they want to carry out further capital investment. They want to invest further. So they don't want to get into debt. So they don't want to spend anything today. In future, they want to do some capital investment. So they refrain from spending it today. The motive of liquidity. What is liquidity? The desire to secure liquid resources to meet emergencies and difficulties. Any amount held as cash or any commodity which can be easily transformed into cash is only called as liquid assets. That which can be cashed very easily are called as liquid assets. So the motive of liquidity, the desire to secure liquid resources to meet emergencies and difficulties. The motive of improvement, the desire to secure a rising income and to demonstrate successful management. The government wants to be successful. They want to increase their income. This is called as the motive of improvement. The motive of financial prudence, the desire to ensure adequate financial provision against depreciation and obsolescence and to discharge debt. The motive of financial prudence, that is the government or the institution or the firms, they want to have adequate financial provision whenever there is a repair or whenever the value is depreciating. Okay, due to usage of machines again and again, sometimes it becomes very obsolete. What do you mean by obsolete? It becomes very old. When they use the machinery again and again, it becomes old. And to pay back the debt, the government wants to have certain amount of money. This is called as the motive of financial prudence. Let us go on to the next one. Objective factors. So far we saw all the subjective factors. So the determinants of consumption can be classified as subjective and objective. Subjective is all which is psychological. Psychological factors are called as subjective factors. These two classification was given by J.M. Keynes. So far we have seen the subjective factors of consumption. Now let us go on to objective factors. What are objective factors? Objective factors are external factors. These factors are real and these can be measured. Subjective factors are psychological factors which happen within a human being. Okay, ullukulla yerpadakoodiya unarva da subjective solra. Velipadaiya kaatakoodiyadhukku peru da annadu objective. They are real, they are measurable. So under this, the first one is income distribution. Distribution. If there is a large disparity between the rich and the poor in a country, if there is a huge difference between the rich people and the poor people, the consumption will be low because the rich people have low propensity to consume and high propensity to save. The rich people want to save more and more. So if the income distribution is unequal or if there is a disparity between the rich and the poor, the consumption will be low. If there is equal distribution of income, then the propensity to consume will be high. So if the income distribution is equal, then the propensity of consumption will be high. Next one is price level. Price level also plays an important role in determining the consumption function. When the price falls, when there is a fall in the price, the real income goes up. The value of money, the real income goes up. People will consume more and the propensity to save of the society increases. So people will consume more and more and the propensity to save of the society will also increase. So price level also plays an important role in determining the consumption level. Next one, wage level. Wage level also plays an important role in determining the consumption function. And there is a positive relationship between wage and consumption. What do you mean by positive relationship? If the wage is high, the consumption will also be high. If the wage is low, the consumption will also be low. Next one is interest rate. Rate of interest plays an important role in determining the consumption function. High rate of interest will encourage people to save more. If the rate of interest is high, people will like to save more. Higher rate of interest will encourage people to save more money and they will reduce their consumption. Next one is fiscal policy. When government reduces the tax, fiscal policy is carried out by the government. When the government reduces the tax, the disposable income of the people rises and the propensity of consumption will also increase. When the propensity of consumption of an individual increases, it also naturally increases the community consumption. When the consumption of an individual increases, the community's consumption also increases. This is due to the fiscal policy. What do you mean by that? When the rate of when the tax rate decreases, இப்போ நான் கட்ட வேண்டிய டாக்ஸ் குறைஞ்சதுன்னா அப்போ நான் செலவழிக்கக்கூடிய வருமானம் எனக்கு அதிகரிக்கும். 10,000 ரூபாய் சம்பளம் வாங்குகிறேன், 1,000 ரூபாய் தான் டாக்ஸ் கட்டுறேன், அப்போ எனக்கு எவ்வளோ காசு மீதி இருக்குது? 9,000 ரூபீஸ் இருக்குது. ஸோ ஐ கேன் ஸ்பெண்ட் மோர். இஃப் த ரேட் ஆஃப் த டாக்ஸ் இன்க்ரீசஸ், இஃப் த டாக்ஸ் ரேட் இஸ் 5,000 ரூபீஸ், தென் மை டிஸ்போசபிள் இன்கம் வில் பி லோ அண்ட் மை கன்சம்ஷன் வில் பி லோ. ஸோ ஃபிஸ்கல் பாலிசி ஆல்சோ பிளேஸ் அன் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ரோல். Next one is consumer credit. What do you mean by consumer credit? The availability of consumer credit at easy installments will encourage households to buy consumer durable goods like automobiles, fridges, computer. This pushes up the consumption. When credit is easily available for the consumers, when the banks or when the shops, they are willing to give goods on installment basis, people tend to buy more and more of consumer goods like washing machine, fridges, laptops and computers. This increases the consumption. So consumer credit also plays an important role. Next one is demographic factors. If the size of the family is large, if there are if a family has 5 or 6 children, the consumption of the family will naturally increase. This is only called as a demographic factors. The larger the size of the family, the greater will be the consumption. Besides the size of the family, stage in family life cycle, place of residence and occupation also affect the consumption. Families with children of college education stage spend more than those of primary education. If a family has grown-up children who are studying in colleges, the college fees will be more, their consumption will be more. If a family has children who are only 1 month or 1 year or 2 years, the consumption will be less. So these are called as demographic factors. Then the place in which you live also. People living in cities will consume more, whereas people living in villages will consume less. Next one is called as the Duesenberry hypothesis. Duesenberry hypothesis. This was given by Duesenberry, an American economist. He made a significant contribution to the Keynesian analysis of income and employment. This is only Duesenberry. He is an American economist. Okay. He has given 2 factors for consumption. First one is called as the consumption expenditure depends not only on the current income, but also on the past income and standard of living. What did Dysenberry say? He says the consumption expenditure depends not only from the not only on the current income. இப்போ வாங்குற வருமானத்தை வச்சு மட்டும் கன்சம்ஷன் செலவு இல்லை, முந்தி நம்மளுடைய இன்கம் எப்படி இருந்தது, அது நம்மளுடைய ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் லிவிங் முந்தி எப்படி இருந்தது. ஒருவேளை என்னுடைய ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் லிவிங் முந்தி ஹையாக இருக்குது, ஹையாக இருந்ததுன்னா இப்போ சம்பளம் கம்மியாக இருந்தால் கூட நான் அதே ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் லிவிங்கில் இருக்கணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு தான் ஆசைப்படுவேன். ஓகே, இதை சொன்னது தான் யார், டிசன்பெரி. தட்ஸ் வை இட் இஸ் கால்ட் இஸ் டிசன்பெரி ஹைபோதசிஸ். த கன்சம்ஷன் எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் டிபெண்ட்ஸ் நாட் ஓன்லி ஆன் த கரண்ட் இன்கம் பட் ஆல்சோ ஆன் த பாஸ்ட் இன்கம் அண்ட் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் லிவிங். ஆஸ் த இண்டிவிஜுவல்ஸ் ஆர் அக்கஸ்டம்ட் டு அ பர்டிகுலர் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் லிவிங், தே கண்டினியூ டு ஸ்பெண்ட் த சேம் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் கன்சம்ஷன் ஈவன் தோ த கரண்ட் இன்கம் இஸ் ரெடியூஸ்ட். ஒருவேளை இப்போ இருக்க இன்கம் ரெடியூஸ் ஆகியிருந்தால் கூட முந்தி அவங்களுடைய நிலைமை நல்லா ஹையாக இருந்ததுன்னா அதே மாதிரி தொடர்ந்து இருக்கணும்னு தான் எல்லாருமே ஆசைப்படுவாங்க. திஸ் இஸ் த ஃபஸ்ட் ஹைபோதிசிஸ் கிவன் பை டிசன்பரி. செகண்ட் ஒன், கன்சம்ஷன் இஸ் இன்ஃப்ளூயன்ஸ்ட் பை டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேஷன் எஃபெக்ட். வாட் டி மீன் பை டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேஷன் எஃபெக்ட்? சம்டைம்ஸ் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ், அவர் நேபர் யூஸஸ் சம் ப்ராடக்ட் அண்ட் வி ஆல்சோ டென் டு யூஸ் த சேம் திங். வி டூ நாட் ஹாவ் மணி, பட் சின்ஸ் த நேபர் ஹஸ் பாட் சம்திங் நியூ, வி ஆல்சோ பை டென் டு பை த சேம் திங். திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேஷன் எஃபெக்ட். இன் தோஸ் டேஸ் வி ஹேட் அ டிவி அட்வர்டைஸ்மெண்ட் ஃபார் ஒனிடா, ஒனிடா டிவி. த அட்வர்டைஸ்மெண்ட் சேஸ் ஓனர்ஸ் ப்ரைட் அண்ட் நேபர்ஸ் என்வி. அந்த டிவியை வச்சுருந்தா ஓனருக்கு பெருமையாக இருக்குமா, ஆனால் பக்கத்து வீட்டுக்காரனுக்கு எப்படி இருக்குமா, பொறாமையாக இருக்குமா. ஸோ வென் அப்போ இது இப்படி தான் ஒரு அட்வர்டைஸ்மெண்ட் வரும் முந்தி ஒனிடா டிவிக்கு. தட் இஸ் இஸ் ட்ரைங் டு சே இஃப் சம்படி பைஸ் அ டிவி யூ கேன் ஆல்சோ பை த சேம் டிவி பிகாஸ் இட் கிவ்ஸ் யூ ஸோ மச் ஆஃப் ப்ரைட். திஸ் எஃபெக்ட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் த டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேஷன் எஃபெக்ட். கன்சம்ஷன் இஸ் இன்ஃப்ளூயன்ஸ் பை டெமான்ஸ்ட்ரேஷன் எஃபெக்ட். த கன்சம்ஷன் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் லோ இன்கம் குரூப்ஸ் ஆர் இன்ஃப்ளூயன்ஸ் பை த கன்சம்ஷன் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் ஆஃப் த ஹை இன்கம் குரூப். வென் த லோ இன்கம் குரூப் பீப்புள் லுக் அட் தி ஹை இன்கம் பீப்புள் and when they see them using everything, the low income people also want to buy the same goods which the high income people use. So here the consumption increases. They want to imitate the rich people. The poor people want to imitate the rich people. This results in spending beyond their income. Such an effect is called as the demonstration effect. These two points are very, very important, girls. Last one is windfall gains or losses. Sudden gain ஆர் சடன் லூஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் விண்ட்ஃபால். எப்படி ஒரு காட்சி வந்து திடீர்னு வருது, எப்போ வருதுன்னே தெரியாதோ, அதே மாதிரி சடன்னாக ஒரு லாபமோ நஷ்டமாக ஏற்பட்டால் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் அஸ் விண்ட்ஃபால் கெயின் ஆர் விண்ட்ஃபால் லூசஸ். அன்எக்ஸ்பெக்டட் சேஞ்சஸ் இன் த ஸ்டாக் மார்க்கெட் லீடிங் டு கெயின்ஸ் ஆர் லாசஸ் டென் டு ஷிஃப்ட் த கன்சம்ஷன் ஃபங்க்ஷன் அப்வர்ட் ஆர் டவுன்வர்ட். நிறைய லாபம் கிடச்சதுன்னா கன்சம்ஷன் வில் இன்க்ரீஸ், நிறைய நஷ்டம் ஏற்பட்டதுன்னா கன்சம்ஷன் வில் டிக்ரீஸ். ஸோ தீஸ் ஆர் த ஆப்ஜெக்டிவ் ஃபேக்டர்ஸ். ஸோ ஃபார் வி ஹவ் சீன் த டிட்டர்மினன்ஸ் ஆஃப் கன்சம்ஷன் ஃபங்க்ஷன். த டிட்டர்மினன்ஸ் ஆஃப் கன்சம்ஷன் ஃபங்க்ஷன் கேன் பி கிளாசிஃபைட் இன்டூ டூ, த சப்ஜெக்டிவ் அண்ட் தி ஆப்ஜெக்டிவ். தீஸ் டூ கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன் வாஸ் கிவன் பை ஜேஎம் கீன்ஸ். அண்டர் சப்ஜெக்டிவ் ஃபேக்டர்ஸ் யூ ஹாவ் டூ ஹெட்ஸ். ஒன் இஸ் கன்சம்ஷன் பை த இண்டிவிஜுவல்ஸ் and the next one is consumption by the government institutions and firms. Under individuals we saw 8 heads and under government institution and firms we saw 4 side headings. Next we saw the objective factors. Under objective factors we saw 9 factors which influence the consumption. I think we can stop with this today. Certain questions that you will get as homework: state the propositions of Keynes' psychological law of consumption. This is a 3-mark question, question number 30. State the proposition of Keynes' psychological law of consumption. Next one, explain any 3 subjective and objective factors influencing consumption function. This, the answer is found on page 58. So for this, you can write any 3 subjective and 3 objective factors. 36th question. Explain Keynes' psychological law of consumption function with a diagram. 36th question. Explain Keynes' psychological law of consumption function with a diagram. Again, 37, you have the same question. Explain the subjective and objective factors of consumption function. This is asked as a 5-mark question. So you will be expected to write at least 5 in the subjective and 5 in the objective. So these are the homework questions for you. I will post the questions again in the Google Classroom as well as in the WhatsApp group. Please do your homework, start writing your class works. And when you write the assignment, you are requested to write the assignment only on one side. If you write it on both the sides, as soon as the school reopens and when I check it physically, I will make you write the same assignment again, girls. So please don't write the assignment on both the sides. Please write the assignments only on one side. Homework should be written only in your homework notebook. Classworks must be written in your classwork notebook. You must have got your classwork notebooks. So please draw the double margin. Write the 2 marks and the 3 marks questions. Okay. 1-word questions, you can write it in your assignment paper and file it up in your economics files. Thank you, girls.